Hey y'all, I'm getting ready to go on and we about to talk health and nutrition. Y'all ready? Well, ain't nobody there. Hey, Cousin Michelle. All right. Let's see here. Oh, one more thing. Forgot. That way I can kind of see who's watching. All right. Let's see if we are ready to get started here, people. All right, so welcome. Welcome to, turn this down. So, hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Jacki-Lynn, just fixing the camera a little bit. All right, so that should be a little bit better. I know you saw the mess on the floor. That's for me dumping the groceries. All right, so I think this will work. I'm trying to be upright and make sure my face is completely in the camera and you still get some of what I'm showing you on the table and what I'm trying to show you in the background as well. So. Once again, today we're going to be talking about, left my rag, we're cleaning. And so this is live, so that's how things go. All right, so I'm just getting back from the store. And I am getting ready to wipe off all my packages. So before I started to wipe off all the packages, I decided to lay everything out and just come on live and have a conversation with my fam and talk about health and nutrition and fighting, having a good immune system, okay? So as you can see, I'm taking down the braids. I'm rocking ear rehab. Hi, I don't know who's saying hi, but I can't wave because the phone's way over there. But I am rocking ear rehab today. This is a beautiful woman who hand makes and handcrafts, a handcraft artisan who makes earrings, and she has jewelry boxes for the earrings. And I won't say what else she makes. I'll let her put up that, but. If you're interested, ear rehab, E-A-R, and then R-E-H-A-B, to purchase your own. These are some of my favorite because they're artistic and I love art. So let's get started with talking about, I only want to be on for like half an hour because I have other things to do. But we're going to talk about health and we're going to talk about immunity. Everybody out here is talking about, you know, trying to stay healthy with COVID and this big push about health recently. But this is something that we should have already been on this kick. It shouldn't be something that is new. So what I'm showing you on the computer screen, if you could see in the background, and I'm hoping you can. I think you can. Pull her closer. All right, so if you could see, hopefully, that is me. That is Jacqueline. I'm Jacki-Lynn now. As Sasha Fierce, as Beyonce said, I have come to Sasha Fierce myself, okay? And so I'm no longer this human being anymore. I used to be 400 pounds, and that's what that picture shows right there, a 400-pound individual. Hold on, because we're teaching today. All right, so you could be watching anything else. You could be watching other things, but if you're watching me right now, that means that you are coming here to learn a little bit about some healthy things from somebody who has experience, from somebody who has been, let me take this down. I no longer need this. From somebody who has been overweight pretty much my entire life, if you really want to get technical. So this particular person on this screen, this individual right here, this is not anybody that came to be new. This is somebody that grew from a child, okay? From PTSD, from all other things. And we could talk about all that later. But in the end, by the time this individual became a person, this 40, almost 40-year-old person right here, or 40-year-old, actually, because I was over 40 when this picture was taken, asthma, eczema, migraines, okay, endometriosis, fibroids, hey, get money, So I still like to party back then, fibroids, ovarian cysts, fibrocystic breast, IBS, laryngitis, sinusitis, plantar fasciitis, ankle fractures and sprains, gallstones, diverticulitis, high blood pressure, high LDL cholesterol, prediabetes, edema, and the list went on and on. This, it did not stop here with that, okay? So I put down here, what the hell? I thought I was cute on that picture. I really did. Okay, you couldn't tell me nothing on that picture. I had on my swimsuit. I had on my my crochet outfit, and I thought I was the bomb, right? And it's okay to still feel the bomb when you're overweight and when you're healthy. You should still feel good about yourself. But when I looked at that picture and I saw that, because it was a Polaroid shot. So that particular day, that moment was a sweet moment for more than one occasion. It was a sweet moment because I realized when I saw that Polaroid picture, oh, hell no. Hell to the no, 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 no. This is not going to work. Okay? This is not going to work. No matter how I try to mask it with a smile, it's not going to work. No matter how cute I look with my outfits and all of that, it's not going to work. Okay? It wasn't going to work. So that is when I decided to dig in and become my own healthcare professional for my own body. And that is when I purchased books and started reading and started digging in. And so now I have thousands of hours of reading, of notes, 10 crates full of mind map notes that I'm ready to push out there on my website, ready to push out into a book, ready to help each other, people out. This is not something new for me. This is the way I live. We're going to talk about all of this right now, but then we're going to talk about tomorrow. We're going to talk about herbs, and you're going to see my herb kitchen in the cabinet, so you can see how I use that to heal myself. Because the body is healing. I want everyone to go get this book right here. Go purchase this book. This book is by Dr. Romeo Brooks, PhD, okay, with the roots in Los Angeles, African-American gentleman. This book, look at it, not a thick read, but a good read. Okay. As you can see, I have lit this book up. And every chapter in this book, I have a mind map for that I will be sharing on my site. But I lit it up. I've read it more than once. There's some chapters that had to get a little bit more. I don't play when it comes to stuff like this. So, this is what I'm going to be sharing with you. It's all the research from books like this. First book I want you to get is The Body Intelligence, so you can understand how intelligent your body is. Your body is intelligent. Your body is supernatural. The problem is, everybody's out there trying to do this right here. Everybody's partying. Hey. Everybody's out there trying to get money. Everybody's trying to stick each other for the paper, for the na-na. Everybody's out there distracted. And so the world, like Beyonce said, hey, just stopped. And it stopped with COVID. It stopped with this disease that I mind mapped. That's just the first page. I did 10 pages because that's where this led me, okay? And my main thing right now, because you can look at my other video on YouTube to go into the details of that. You really can. So I'm not going into the details of all of that. What I'm going into right now is the white cells. Because the main thing about SARS, which is where COVID originated, okay? The main thing about SARS, where's my book? Hold on. This book. Purchased this a while ago. Hey guys, this book right here, The Little Book of Pandemics by Dr. Peter Moore, okay? I got this book from my book crew in my building. We exchange books. We have a little house where you give a book, get a book. And this book I got months ago, okay? I got this months ago. And together, when I got this book, guess what's right there? What does it say? SARS. SARS. And what does it say about SARS? That it is associated coronavirus. So I went to mind mapping the hell out of it and said, okay, if that's what it comes from and that's what it is, then let me get to it. So I realized how it spread, but then I realized the main thing right here. This right here is the main thing. These two things, white blood cells and platelets. Your white blood cells, let's go into that mind map. White blood cells. When you with me, this is what I do when I coach you. This is what happens. We break things down. I don't play. When I teach, I don't play. This is your white blood cells. So I did a research run all about your white blood cells. Okay? And basically, that's everything. Your immunity. You need them to fight everything. Okay? They're larger than red blood cells, first of all. They pass through the wall, so they move independently through the bloodstream, right? They move independently through the bloodstream. So they're on their own. They have different kinds of white blood cells, but the main thing, if you want to know this, you can look at this later. But the basic thing is that they are fighting the foreigners. All my cars are foreign. Well, I don't want no foreign cars in here. I don't want foreign cars in my driveway, in my garden. No. Okay? Because that means that that's toxic bacteria, fungi, infection that causes infection. We don't want that. So the white blood cells, some of them ingest and they destroy. Ingest it and destroy it. They ingest the toxins and they destroy it. Then you have your B cells and your T cells and the natural killers. B cells in the bone marrow, T cells in the thymus. Where's your thymus? Right here, right above your chest. So it's kind of theoretical with the lung situation and COVID that makes sense, that's the first to go is your lungs. Or that's the hardest part to fight off is the lungs, because your white blood cells have been depleted. What did it say? They're almost depleted. They dramatically go down massively, and then the blood platelets can't clot your tissues when they're damaged. It puts you at a highly vulnerable state. Now, if you're already vulnerable and you're already overweight, diabetes, immune compromised, then you're going to have even more issues. If you're immune compromised already, your white blood cells are already low. So if you get this disease, you're really going to have a hard time fighting that off even more. The thymus is the major immune system gland. That's where your T cells are made. The major immune system gland. Okay, guys? I don't know what happened to my music. There we go. So, it's the garbage collector. It collects the garbage in your body, okay? It keeps you from aging. But if you're obese and you're making too many cytokines, then you become inflamed, and you're highly inflamed, and you're highly probable to get disease. And what is disease? Let's go there. What is disease? Disease is dis-ease. It means it's a dis-ease. Dis-ease of the body. Hey, I'm good. Hey. So, that's the body's dis-ease. Your body is supplied with all its biological needs. But what happens? We interfere with it. We hamper it by eating the junk that we eat. We hamper it because we sit up and drink ourselves to oblivion. Yes, I'm having a glass of wine right now, but I don't drink myself into oblivion. It's okay to have one. It's okay to have a glass. Some doctors say it's okay to have a glass or two a night. I'm not going to do that. But my point is, you have to take care of your body. And this table right here that I'm about to go through is taking care of your body. When you're trying to fight immune system and you're trying to have healthy white blood cells, you need a proper, nutritious diet. So here's the next book. I'm not playing with you guys. You're going to take my class, then you're going to enroll. You're going to learn about your body. You're going to cultivate thyself. You want to know how I got from here to here I am now, and still losing and still toning and doing those things and not having so much loose skin from doing all of this? It's from reading. I don't waste my time watching television all day. I have my shows that I watch every now and then, but I am a reader. When I wanted to find out how I'm going to deal with this body, the doctors were not curing me. I was tired of spending money at the doctor's office, going back and forth trying to find out for all these different illnesses. If you notice, all of them have itis. A lot of them have itis. Itis is inflammation. Anything with itis means it's inflammation. So getting on an anti-inflammatory diet, doing things that help boost your immunity system, that is what you need to be doing. So this is one book that I purchased. If you're in Los Angeles, I'm a frequent customer of, what's my place? I can't think of it right now. Everybody knows I'm Overhill and Flossin. It's the only natural place store in LA for us, as far as African American people. Simply Wholesome, okay? So, pretty much these two books I purchased from Simply Wholesome, okay? These two books saved my life right here. We're going to be talking about these two books because in this one book, it talks about herbs and prescriptions. And if you don't want to buy the book and you just want to take my course and want to go through it with me and we mind map it and go through it together, we could do that, okay? We could do that. But it gives you the herbs, it gives you the nutrients for whatever. As you can see, it's all tabbed up for my different issues. For example, for an alkaline diet, my daughter and my family have boils, for sinusitis, for pain. Anything that I'm experiencing, I go to my books and I find out. I also go to the internet as well. I get my resources, and I speak to health professionals as well. I know nurses and doctors as well. So when I'm coming to you with information, know that I'm not coming to you just with no regular BS. I'm coming to you with knowledge that I've gained. I am an educator, okay? I do have a degree. I have 2 degrees. I have a degree from Pepperdine University as my bachelor's in sociology, and I have a master's in education and a teaching credential in urban education. So I'm not here to just fool you. I'm not here to just take your money. I'm really here to help people and help people get healthy in the right way. And I want you to cultivate yourself. So that's why I'm giving you the books and everything to read. I want you to go out and read for yourself. Not just take my word for it. Not just take my mind maps. But you go out there and you do it for yourself. Because this is with me, right? Ooh, yeah. So that was, let me see, that was last summer. I was coming down. I'm smaller than that now, but that was last summer. And that was in Cancun. No, where were we? Cabo? Cancun? I don't know where we were. My bestie's a travel agent, the best travel agent on the planet. And we go all over the place. And I think that was the summer. Oh, that was for Titi's birthday. So my little cousin's birthday. And we were deep. That one, I'll have to show you the video from that one day. When we were getting on the bus, I might show that at the end if I can find it. But we were getting, it was 30 something of us that went on this trip, and we had a ball, let me tell you. And we basically shut it down. I'll probably show some at the end if I can find some. But you saw the white and the contrast with the white. The reason why I did that was because I wanted you to see the difference. Time. That's all it was time. Time, knowledge, patience, and mind. I had to mind fuck my mind. Like, excuse my French, but I had to really F my mind up. And I had to rewire it, okay? And I'm going to teach you all of that. When the website opens up and everything, and you want to join and you want to work with me, that's what we're going to do. It's not just about the food. It is not about the exercise. It is really right here. Right here is where it is, between these two noggins right here. So that is the main thing we get started with first, is going with this, and then we go into that. So, foods, vitamin C, and then let's get going. So as I'm wiping down the packages, this is broccoli. Okay, so this was my haul today. I had to do a vegetable haul. The other day was a fruit haul. So I'm going to re-wipe them down again, but I'm just showing you what I do. This towel has bleach and water, and I have a little container that I use to rinse it out and do that. So basically, I just wanted to show you how I do the wipe off. But the foods here are things that, especially during COVID, during this quarantine, you want to still eat healthy. Even if you're not doing keto and you're trying to do keto, or you're trying to just eat healthy-wise, these are some items that you can use, that you can freeze, that that will work well in your kitchen, that also boost the immune system, okay? So let's talk about the particular ones that you're going to use. Okay, so, like I said, that was what I came to. This was what I was. That's what I was. Let's enlarge that. Do we see that? That was me. Okay, that was me. That still is me in a sense, if you want to get technical. I'm looking for my pointer. It fell over. But that still is me in a sense. But let's talk about it. Me. I didn't eat all this kind of stuff when this was me. No. I was the queen of fast food, the queen of, because I'm busy. I'm an educator, a single mother. And I was in school. So it ended up, next thing you know, I was 400 pounds after just not really realizing that I'm not taking care of myself. I looked up and that's what happened. Literally, I looked up and I was 400 pounds. And I used to watch the 600 pound life and be like, oh, well, how did that happen with people? Oh, how did it get like that? I know how it got like that. Behind all these smiles was a depressed individual, but not really knowing that I was depressed. But it turns out, as you learn more about it, there are certain signs and symptoms of it that I catch myself now falling into. But this particular person was not a happy person, okay? This particular person would never have come on channel like this with the hair just like this and been done. No. Having fun at Santa Monica Pier, okay? In my classroom, having a nice time visiting students. This particular guy came in, we're having career day, and he was a football player, and he came in. This one is at my parents' house, okay? And we're having, I don't know what it was. It could have been my birthday. I don't know. This one, I was taking my nephew to drop him off at the airport. He was going away to Norway, and this was me then. This was me coming down, so I just did a side-by-side comparison so you could see that change does occur over time, okay? All right, and then this was me at my brother's wedding, okay? And that is me at my mom's, I think it was her 60th birthday party. Hi, whoever just came on. I can't wave with the thing because I'm far away, but I see you. But these are pictures of me then, okay? And then these are pictures of me now. You see the smile is a little bit different, isn't it? You know what I mean? I'm feeling her right here, for real. I'm feeling her right here. This person is the business right now. This person has been celibate also for 8 years, okay? I didn't even realize that that's part of depression. I didn't even realize all of that, okay? And this person is happy, and this person has cultivated thyself into a sexy fit, which is what I'm trying to help you do, okay? See the difference in the classroom picture? That's one classroom picture. And then go back. And look at that, look at that classroom picture. Two totally different people, right? I'm not feeling this song. All right, flashing lights, yeah. So this is me, the summer, having some fun, okay? This is me in Vegas. This is me in the classroom again. Having some fun, right? Right. This is what I became. I turned myself into this person. I was not that person. You saw what the picture was before. This was in, I don't know where we were here. This might have been the same trip right here. This was Cancun last year. Yeah, so last year, that's when the weight really was off, and I was like, whoa, like, you could really see a dramatic change, and that was after I really got into keto. So this is after really, I really came down with keto from here to here was a huge difference. And here, I was feeling myself. We had a ball. We did two hotels that trip. We was gone for like a 7-day trip. So, my point with that is, this was me, right? Look at that. I'm showing you all this to show you why I eat like this now. This is why. Eating like this is what got me here. Cutting out cereal. I don't buy cereal. Cutting out bread. I don't do bread. And a whole lot of other tips that when you join the Keto Babe Challenge and you follow and you join the Cultivate Thyself group, you will get more of those tips as to how to get to where you need to go. I can't give it all away, right? But, because I work hard. You see the mind mapping. I work hard to write the books and the things for you. I work hard. This was my 400 pound life. I deliberately defined my desire, dream, reality. I did it within my 983 square foot apartment. In a suburban neighborhood, I sacrificed, okay? with surgery, no personal trainer, no gym. So if you've been following me, you see my workout, me working out in my apartment. I've had multiple surgeries. I don't want surgery again. So that's why I didn't want to go that route. Okay, I have scars from that. I'm gutted from that, from surgeries that I've had, over five, from my illnesses. So this is not a joke to me. This is something that's serious to me. I had to lose this weight in order to have another surgery that I need to have. So having an appearance surgery or a plastic surgery is not something I really want to do, especially when I have to have surgeries for medical purposes. So hopefully the natural health will help me so I don't have to have this next surgery. But if I do, now I can have it because I've lost the weight and I'm not high risk anymore. So how did I do that? I had the mind script. This did not happen overnight. This person did not happen overnight. It did happen with keto and intermittent fasting and some other things. Like right now, I haven't eaten in 3 days. I don't even care, which is probably why I have the energy and the mind to come on right now, because my mind is just, but I haven't really had a real meal in maybe 2 or 3 days, maybe, because my body is so trained in the fasting that I'm hungry now, and so that's why I'm ready to munch on all this stuff. But my body is trained to fast. My body is trained. We'll talk about why fasting works and why combining that with keto works and how to do that in a healthy way. Because I went from this to there. And that was what I do for myself is a tip. I don't celebrate with food. I celebrate. I love clothes and shoes. I'm a shoe whore. I'll call myself that. I'm a shoe whore and a clothes whore. Fashion. I like fashion. I like jewelry. I like clothes. So instead of rewarding myself with food and clothes, food, and say, oh, I'm going to reward myself with some ice cream. I'm going to go eat here. No, I am going to get a new dress. Like, that's what I'm going to do. And this was one of the dresses that I got. Ooh, I got a one that's coming on right now. This is my new one. So, I'm getting ready to get into this Michael Kors one right here, right? That's the one I'm working on right now. So, this is the one that I'm working on for somebody to come and take me out on a date when this is all over with. Because I'm getting myself right and getting toned for that right now. Okay. So, yeah. So, this is what I'm working on now with this dress. So, what I do is I buy a dress before I can fit it. Or an outfit before I can fit it. Like the workout outfit, the Nike outfit I bought. And I will go buy that outfit and I'll hang it up in the closet. Not even in the closet, I'll hang it up on the door. And that is my motivation because I want to get into that outfit. For me, my big action was about me wanting to wear a certain outfit. And so that was the outfit that I bought. And then eventually, one day, I was able to wear it and I wore it to a business meeting. So this is my next outfit. It's kind of tight right now. And by the time I get into it, it's going to fit nice and right. I got some red shoes that I want to, or maybe I'll go buy some shoes. That'd be my next purchase, to go buy some shoes to go with that outfit. I think I will because the red ones are older. So, food, broccoli, greens, okay? The greens. These can be frozen, okay? That's why I bought these. I don't want to go back out to the store right now. And even if I didn't, this is what I would buy regularly. This is not something I buy just because it's COVID and we're quarantined. This is how I eat on a regular basis. So greens, I got the, normally I buy fresh, but I brought the frozen kind because I don't want to go out and I don't want them to go bad. So I'm going to store those in the freezer. Then these, my broccoli, we can blanch these and blanch them and freeze them. And we can also blanch and freeze these items as well. These are items that go good to snack on. So instead of chips and all the junk food and french fries and all that and cookies, I don't buy all that. You see, I don't have a lot of packaged items. It's killing me to go canned food because I normally go whole. So that's an, these are good vitamin A and vitamin C immunity boosting food. A bag of lemons. I buy lemons by the bag because I eat them every day. Lemons are huge in vitamin C to fight immunity, okay? If you are thinking about the flu, and you're even if you were fighting off inflammation or fighting off the flu or anything like that, or influenza, vitamin A, vitamin C, it helps strengthen the immune system by increasing the number of quality white blood cells. So this is the stuff that's going to increase those white blood cells that we talk to help boost that immunity. To help boost that immunity. So this is one, vitamin C. Another, ginger. And all this is not expensive, guys, okay? Let's be real here. A pound of ginger. This is a pound of ginger right here. I eat ginger like nobody's business because I put it in my tea every day. And I cook with it. Ginger is very good and it's a great immune booster. Vitamin C. Okay? We have dry beans. Always keep you some dry beans for emergency situations anyway. So I'm going to make some chili or some soup with the northern beans. What else do we have here? Let's see. We have some peppers. Yeah, let's go to the peppers. And with the peppers, these are good as well to help boost your immune system. These are good to cook with. Sometimes I just dip these in some hummus or something like that. All of these are items that could be just snacks, right? Oh no, I'm sorry. I'm a music person, so if you know, I'm going through my playlist because I, I apologize. I'm looking for a certain playlist. Give me 1 second, y'all. Oh, well. I got caught up in the music. Oh, my apologies. Where is that playlist? Oh, well, my apologies. I got caught up. So, continuing, and then we're going to finish up so you can go on. And talking about beans, tomato paste. All right, so tomato paste. We have canned beans. Usually I don't like to do canned beans. Grape tomatoes, meat. Keto is about meat, okay? The healthy keto is not just about meat, but having some sausage leaving for breakfast. You can do what you want with this. There's a lot of things you can do with the sausage. And this is just a small haul. Okay. Diced green onions. Now, what I do with this, the reason why I bought the jar is because when these go out, I just refill the jar. Okay. I don't have to have those kind all the time. You keep your garlic. These are all immunity boosting foods. Your garlic, your onions. You have sweet potato. What else we have? That's pretty much it. Oh, right here. avocado. Right here. Key. Okay. What else? Oh, pickles. My favorite. Now, pickles are for something else, too. Hey. So, pickles are for if you get cramps in the middle of the night and you have trotty horses, pickle juice is something that can really help you with that, okay? So, pickle juice. Pickle juice is one of my favorite things to drink when I have a cramp in the middle of the night. There's an old wives' tale to say you can go to salt and do salt at the bottom and put it on the floor and things like that, but you could do that as well. We're almost done with the haul. Let me take our time and take it easy. Take it easy. Yes, we ain't gotta be fired right now, but my next dude, that's how it gotta be. Look. And take it easy, baby. Highway. Tofu. Now, I don't eat a lot of tofu because of the estrogen, but you can do tofu eggs, a lot of things you can do with that. So when we start making recipes, I'll let you know I'm going live to make a thing. Lucky, lucky, love me. All right, this one has DHA and omega-3. I have to get my omega-3 from other places because I can't. I'm allergic to seafood. Let me take our time. This is Danny Lee. And take it easy. So tofu is good. You can freeze tofu. Make eggs, a lot of things you could do, all of that. I'll be posting recipes. We're going to have a good time cultivating myself. Yes. And take it easy. That's the haul for today. The other thing I did go out and get, running through the highway, that way. I did get some of this. I do have emergency stuff for acute situations. So, lucky, Theraflu, and some DM, Robitussin. You know how in Chris Rock, where his mama say, Robitussin cure everything. Give him some of that Tussin. So, these two I keep in the cabinet for emergencies, but I do also have all natural health. But just in case, I'm not stupid, I do have acute stuff. That is it. And take it easy. That's what I want you to do right now. You don't have to decide right now. But. And take it easy, baby. I want you to take it easy over this time. And I want you to think about how you're going to spend the rest of your time quarantine. Every day I'm going to be coming on with something different. Today was about the haul today. The vegetable haul that I got today. The other day was a fruit haul. And we'll talk about how to do keto and do it in a modified way if you join the group. The Cultivate Thyself group. And if you decide to join the challenge, we're going to restart the challenge in April. But you can still join the group and follow. You can follow me everywhere at Linktree. Find all my links. LINKTR. /cultivate CULTIVE8 thyself THYSELF. And I hope you got something out of this today. To know that you can transform your life. That this was me. Does that look like me now? No, it doesn't. It still is me, but it's not me. Ear rehab, thank you. If you want to deliberately cultivate yourself and you want to deliberately define your desired reality, whatever that may be, I don't know what you're, how lost you are in your life right now. This is not just about weight. It's about more than that. It's about way more than that. You can't keep it off just by exercising. It's always about the choices that you make. And the choices that you make are based upon the thoughts that you have inside your head. So the mental part of the body is really important. We're going to be digging into the mental body, the emotional body, the physical body, the sexual body, and the spiritual body. And I don't mean spiritual as in religious, I mean spiritual as in soul. So if you're somebody or you know somebody who is on that path and wants to become a balanced being and stop being a sad human being, and you want a bright and colorful transformation, and you are ready to cultivate thyself, then follow me on Instagram at Cultivate Thyself. Follow me on Facebook. Join the Cultivate Thyself group. Go through my links. I also am homeschooling as well. I'm a teacher trainer, so I'm doing that as well. That website is coming soon. I also do a lot. I'm a jack of all trades. That's Jacki-Lynn. So you got questions, you have questions, come see me. My tutoring school is opening up soon. Come talk to me about that. Your kids having struggle. I have created something called the 3D read problem solving technique, I guess you can call it. So we'll be working with that. And www.homeschoolingforall.com. If you are a teacher, teachers using Zoom and distance learning. This is my song, y'all. And we're going to go out on this song. Yes. We're going to go out with Cruising, Vitamin C. Baby, 9-11 with Cruising. Movement. You ready? Choosing. Baby, I'm the one that you're. Hey, are you ready to cruise along on this health journey with me? So, get this book, Romeo Brooks, Body Intelligence, Nutrition. Yes. And then see if you're ready to go from there. Baby, 9-11, we're cruising. You ready to cruise with me? Yeah. I'm your favorite. I'm the only one you choosing. I don't want it. I'm not that person anymore. If you're that person and you want to change, let's forget about it. Gonna forget about that person, because now this is the new person. If you're ready to transform your life and cruise with me and make that your former, hey, let's forget about it.
Baby, 9-11, we're cruising. Movement. I'm the only one that you're choosing.
I'm your favorite.
I'm the only one.
Enjoy your evening. One last thing for immunity, L-lysine. We'll talk about that too. And then we'll talk about these. See, this was me on a regular basis going to the doctor. Right here. That was me all the time. Going to the doctor for this. Going to the doctor for that. That was her. And I got tired of this. So. Ooh, sorry about that. Trying to find the one that could fix me. But it was heartless. Hey. I want it all. But I couldn't have it all. Why? Because this was keeping me sick. So, if you're tired of this, getting stuck with these all the time, then continue to watch, continue to follow. I keep these up here for motivation, to remind me of why I do what I do. Because the world is heartless sometimes. And you gotta take care of yourself. Cultivate thyself. Let's get ready to see your before and your after. And your transformation. Have a great evening. Pleasure to come with you and co-create with you if you stuck with me the whole time. I tried to keep it under a half an hour, but you know how I do. If you got tired of watching, pause it, go back and watch the rest. I'm not going to apologize for being me. And for teaching and learning and helping. I love you out there. Take care of yourself. Namaste. Cause I'm hollering.